الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على المبعوث رحمة للعالمين أبا القاسم محمد وعلى آل بيته الطيبين الطاهرين. اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد وعجل فرجهم ولعن أعدائهم أجمعين من الآن إلى قيام يوم الدين. السلام عليكم جميعا ورحمة الله وبركاته. In the last few nights, we spoke about the concept of imama, and we spoke about the concept of being appointed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and not by people. And we also spoke about Amir al-Mu'mineen being the divided appointed leader for mankind after the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. After we understood all these things, now it's time for us to see how far can me and you go when it comes to holding on to this wilayah, to this concept of leadership. As you all know, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was instructing the Muslims to have love for the Ahlul Bayt in the Quran, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, قُلْ لَا أَسْأَلُكُمْ عَلَيْهِ أَجْرًا إِلَّا الْمَوَدَّةَ فِي الْقُرْبَى. I ask you for no reward except to show love and compassion towards my family. A man came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi and he said to him, هَلْ يَنْفَعُنِي حُبُّ عَلِيُّ بْنُ أَبِي طَالِبْ عَلَيْهِ السَّلَامِ. Will the love of Ali help me in any way? The Prophet says to him, وَيْحَكْ. Woe be unto you. مَنْ أَحَبَّهُ أَحَبَّنِي. Whoever loves him, loves me. وَمَنْ أَحَبَّنِي أَحَبَّ اللَّهِ. And whoever loves me, loves Allah. وَمَنْ أَحَبَّ اللَّهِ لَمْ يُعَذِّبْهُ. And whoever loves Allah, he will not be punished. So loving Amir al-Mu'mineen is like loving Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, يا سلمان, he's talking to Salman al-Muhammadi, حب علي إيمان. His love is a sign of إيمان, belief in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وبغضه نفاق, and hating him is a sign of hypocrisy. والله لا يحبه إلا مؤمن. By Allah, only a believer would love him. ولا يبغضه إلا منافق. And only a hypocrite would hate أمير المؤمنين. So when we talk about the concept of love and hate, not the feeling love, because you could love a lot of things that not necessarily you follow, not necessarily that you hold dear and close. For example, when you say, I love my car, I love my phone, I love my house, not necessarily they mean anything to you. They're just worldly positions. But when we say we love Amir al-Mu'mineen, or we love Ahlul Bayt alayhim as-salam, it means that we need to submit to them. We need to submit to their leadership, because everything in life, it must run through the system of leadership. When there's a leader in place, people need to follow that leader. If you are not following that leader, then there is no point of you following. So what's the point of me saying I'm a follower of the Ahlul Bayt, but yet alone I don't practice, I don't follow their teachings? It's pointless, isn't it? So when we submit to the Ahlul Bayt alayhim as-salam, we submit it through the process of thinking, through the process of understanding. When we find them worthy enough of us following them, then we follow them. A man by the name Amr ibn al-Hamaq al-Khiza'i, he came to Amir al-Mu'mineen salamullah alayhi in the Battle of Safin. And he said, he made this statement, he says, Wallahi, ma ju'tika li malin min ad-dunya ta'tini. I did not come with you in the Battle of Safin for money that you will give me. وَلَا لِإِلْتِمَاسِ سُلْطَانٍ تَرْفَعْ بِهِ ذِكْرِي. Nor do I seek a position like a rank in your army so I could be remembered by. إِلَّا لِأَنَّكَ ابْنَ عَمِّ رَسُولِ اللَّهِ. Except for the fact that you are what? The cousin of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وآله. وَأَوْلَى النَّاسِ بِالنَّاسِ. You are the most rightful leader to lead man or to lead men. So he's looking at it from the concept of what? Of his traits, of his virtues, not on from the fact of love, just the feeling love towards him. And then he says, وَزَوْجُ فَاطِمَةَ سَيِّدَةِ نِسَاءِ الْعَالَمِينَ. and you are the husband of Fatima al-Zahra. And then he keeps going until he gets to the point where he says, Wallah, by Allah I swear, لو كلفتني نقل الجبال الرواسي, if you ask me to move the heaviest of the mountains, ونسح البحور الطوامي, and to empty the deepest of seas, أبدا حتى يأتي علي يومي, until I die, وفي يدي سيفي أهز به عدوك وأقوي به وليك ويعلى به كعبك ويفلج به حجتك, ما ظننت أني أديت من حقك كل الحق الذي يجب عليك أو يجب لك علي. He says, if I do all these things, if I move the mountains, empty the seas, I fight your enemy, I make you the leader of man, I do all these things, at the end of the day, I see myself what? I have not done one right of your rights. One simple thing towards you I have not achieved. For this, Amir al-Mu'minin salamullah alayhi said to him, Allahumma nawwar qalbahu bil yaqeen. Allah, O Allah, enlighten his heart with certainty. Wahdihi ila sirat al-mustaqim. And guide him to the straight path. This is one. Imam al-Sadiq salamullah alayhi, he always constantly remembers Salman al-Muhammadi. He always talks about him. When a companion of the Imam salamullah alayhi, he said to him, Ya Imam, why do you always talk about Salman? What is so special about Salman? And the Imam says, لا تقول سلمان الفارسي. That's the first thing. ولكن قول سلمان المحمدي. So the Imam says he's among Salman from us Ahlul Bayt. So do not call him the Persian or the Farsi. أتدري ما كثرة ذكري له? Do you know why I always remember Salman? قال لثلاث خلال. Three traits, three virtues that Salman had. For these three, I always remember him. One, أحدهما إيثاره هوى أمير المؤمنين عليه السلام هوى نفسه. He always puts أمير المؤمنين before himself. So whenever he sees أمير المؤمنين سلام الله عليه wants something, he will do it. So sometimes it's a conflict. I know it's haram, and Allah, I know Allah does not like it, but then myself, my nafs, my pleasure, desire says, do it. And then I end up doing it. So I put myself before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Salman alayhi radhiwanullah, he always puts Amir al-Mu'mineen before himself. This is the first one. And he says, وَالثَّانِيَ حُبُّهُ لِلْفُقَرَاءِ, his love for the poor people. وَاخْتِيَارُهُمْ إِيَّاهُمْ عَلَىٰ أَهْلِ الثَّرْوَةِ وَالْعَدَدِ, and he chooses them on top of those who are wealthy and have numbers. والثالثة, the third trait, virtues that Salman had that makes me always remember him, حبه للعلم والعلماء, his love for the scholars and for knowledge. وإن سلمان كان عبدا صالحا حنيفا مسلما وما كان من المشركين. So again, he keeps talking about the traits of Salman. But the number one trait, virtue that made Salman special is the fact that what? He always places Amir al-Mu'mineen before his own needs, before his own desires. And if we look at the companions of Amir al-Mu'mineen salamullah alayhim, salamullah alayhi, they always come to Amir al-Mu'mineen and they put him before anything else. So if me and you acclaim to be the lovers of Amir al-Mu'mineen salamullah alayhi, we also need to do the same thing. Now, being a fellow of Amir al-Mu'mineen and saying, I am a Shia, I follow the concept of wilaya. This wilaya, this leadership, this concept of ittiba, of following, it doesn't come cheap. It comes with a heavy price. The early companions of Amir al-Mu'mineen, they paid dearly for it. Their hands were cut. Their legs were cut. Their tongues were cut. They were prisoners. They were poor. Their children were killed. Their women were taken captives. So they had to endure so much just for holding on to this concept of wilaya. So it didn't come cheap. It didn't get to me and you with flowers and sunshine, as we say. It came with a heavy price, with a heavy price tag. Now, I'm going to go through some of the people who had to suffer for the sake of this concept of wilaya, so we could learn something from them, me and you. Amongst the companions that you all know is Ammar ibn Yasir. Right. Ammar ibn Yasir, from day one when he became a Muslim, his mother was martyred, his father was martyred, he was tortured by the mushrikeen of Quraysh. And as he continued being the follower of Amir al-Mu'mineen salamullah alayh, even at the time of Uthman ibn Affan, he was bashed twice by Uthman ibn Affan, as historical narration tell us, because he stood firm when it came to the truth, until he was killed in Safin fighting alongside Amir al-Mu'mineen salamullah alayh. So this man, he paid a heavy price for holding on to this wilaya, to this concept of leadership. Abu Dharr al-Ghifari, for example, he also fought handily for the wilaya of Ahlul Bayt, where wherever he goes, he talks about the merits and the traits and the virtues of Amir al-Mu'mineen, until Uthman could not stand him for one day, so he outcasted him from Medina to Rabada. He threw him in the desert. And what we call these days house arrest. He is under the desert arrest, where he wasn't allowed to come to the Medina, and he died by himself in the desert of Rabada. So he was outcast, he was thrown out of the city because of his love for Amir al-Mu'mineen. So this man had to suffer. Maytham al-Tammar, another companion of Amir al-Mu'mineen salamullah alayhi, he said, "Da'ani Amir al-Mu'mineen alayhi salam maqal." Amir al-Mu'mineen called me and he said, كيف أنت يا ميثم إذا دعاك دعي بني أمية؟ How is it when this treacherous man from Bani Umayyah calls on to you? Ubaydullah ibn Ziyad إلى البراءة مني. When he comes and he says, this Ubaydullah ibn Ziyad, he says to you, now either us or either Ali. Either you come with us and denounce Ali or the sword. And then so he says, فقال فذاك في فذاك في الله قليل. He said, this is a small price to pay for the sake of Allah. So what if I have to give my life for your sake, ya Amir al-Mu'mineen? فقال يا ميثم إذا تكون معي في درجتي. Then you'll be with me in heaven in same level as me. So even though he was foretold that he will be killed, he says, so be it. I don't care. So this is another example of a person who was holding firm to his belief in the wilaya of Amir al-Mu'mineen salamullah alayhi. Even Amir al-Mu'mineen salamullah alayhi, he told him where he will be killed. He told him how he will be killed. He told him they will cut your legs and they will cut your tongue and they will crucify you on a palm tree. And even Amir al-Mu'mineen showed him the tree he was going to get crucified on. And Maytham, he used to come every day water that tree. This is how much love they had for the concept of wilaya. Hijr ibn Adi, another person who was a companion of Amir al-Mu'mineen, where Muawiyah, one day he had this discussion with him, and he was trying to convince him to leave Amir al-Mu'mineen, and Hijr ibn Adi, he refused. So Muawiyah, he ordered his men to kill him and his son. So they asked Hijr, he said, who should we kill first, you or your son? And Hijr said, kill my son first. Which is, you know, usually it's the opposite. A father does not want to see his son killed. So they killed his son in front of him. Then they asked and they said to him, don't you have any mercy that you allow your son to be killed before you? And look at the answer of this man. Look how he's looking at things. He says, خفتُ أن يرى ولدي حول السيف. I was afraid that he might see the consequences of the sword. So if he sees his father gets killed before him, he might get scared, and then he denounces Amir al-Mu'mineen. He says, خفتُ أن يرى ولدي حول السيف على عنقي فيرجع عن ولاية علي بن أبي طالب. This is the amount of love they had. Another person. A man by the name of Shaheed al-Hujri. This guy, Amir al-Mu'mineen salamullah alayhi, came to him. He said to him, Ya Rushayd, كيف صبرك إذا أرسل إليك دعي بني أمية? How would you be patient when the treacherous man of Bani Umayyah calls on to you? فقطع يديك ورجليك ولسانك. And he will cut your hands and your legs and your tongue. يعني what other details could Amir al-Mu'mineen give these guys? He's being very precise. He says, فَقُلْتُ يَا أَمِيرَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ آخر ذَلِكَ الْجَنَّةِ If this happens to me, will I end up in heaven? قَالَ بَلَى Of course, surely. That's the price you pay, you get heaven. And he said, "Anta ma'i fi dunya wal akhirah." Faqal, then he says, his daughter narrates the story. She says, when he came to Ubaydullah ibn Ziyad, Ubaydullah ibn Ziyad, he said to him, "How did your master Ali told you you will die?" He said, "My master told me that my hands and my legs and my tongue will be cut by you." He said, "By God, I will make a liar out of your imam. I'm going to cut your hands and your legs, but not your tongue." And he did. So he cut his legs and his hands, and he threw him outside. When they threw this man, Rushayd al-Hujari, outside, Rushayd, he kept talking about the merits of Amir al-Mu'mineen. He said, "Bring pens and papers and write what I'm about to say to you." So one person went back to Ubaydullah ibn Ziyad and said to him, "This man is talking about Ali and the merits of Ali. He's exposing you." So then Ubaydullah ibn Ziyad, he sent one of his men to cut his tongue. So at the end of the day, exactly as Amir al-Mu'mineen said, happened. Again, you could see how the trend between the holding firm to this wilaya and the consequences and the cost that has to be paid. That me and you, we need to be paid. And for that, every time we remember these guys, whether it's Abu Dharr, Ammar, Al-Muqdad, Maytham, and all these guys, when we remember them, we don't remember them for their salah, for their ibadah, for their fasting. No. We remember them for the stand they took by standing by Amir al-Mu'mineen. And when we remember the other side, we don't remember them for being drunk or for being people who are sinful. But we remember them for the stand against Amir al-Mu'mineen, salamullahi alayhi. So this is how it ends up to be. So me and you here, we have a choice to make as well. We could either stand with Amir al-Mu'mineen salamullah alayhi and support this concept of wilaya, or we go against it, or we be among those who are, in the same time and the same place where Amir al-Mu'mineen salamullah alayhi was asking them to come to his aid and support. They backed off. We could be the same. So imagine this. This could happen to me and you. All right. This happened in many times in Iraq after the fall of Saddam. A lot of people were held captives by the enemies of the Ahl al-Bayt, and they were given the choice. Either you denounce Ali ibn Abi Talib, curse Ali ibn Abi Talib, say bad things about him, we let you live. You don't, we'll kill you. And I've heard a lot of stories about young men who have nothing in terms of knowledge, but they had this love for Ali. They chose death, but not to curse Amir al-Mu'mineen salamullah alayhi. Even though Islamically, jurisprudentially, fiqh-wise, they have the right to curse to save their lives, and they'll be okay. But they refused. They chose death over cursing Amir al-Mu'mineen salamullah alayhi. So me and you, sometimes we might be put in this situation where we have to denounce Amir al-Mu'mineen, or leave this wilaya of Amir al-Mu'mineen, or speak badly about it. Now, what will me and you do? Will we do this, or will we hold firm to this wilaya, to this concept of leadership? That's one. And two, you have to keep in mind that Amir al-Mu'mineen salamullah alayhi, he wants people that follow him as they should. Okay, so when I acclaim to be a companion of Amir al-Mu'mineen, a fellow of Amir al-Mu'mineen, a lover of Amir al-Mu'mineen, when it comes to my actions, how much of it goes in accordance to Amir al-Mu'mineen? So Ali alayhi salam, he's my leader, right? So Ali alayhi salam said to me, "Do not listen to music, for example. Do not backbite. Do not cheat. Don't look at the haram." This is the orders of Amir al-Mu'mineen. He's my commander, he's my master, and he's giving me these orders. So will I obey my commander and hold on firm to this concept of wilayah, or will I come to myself and please myself? What would it be? Amir al-Mu'mineen salamullah alayhi, in a hadith, he says, every time you listen to music, it's like you slap me on the right cheek and the left cheek. That's how he pictures it. So when it comes to our a'mal, our actions, is it in accordance with Amir al-Mu'mineen, or is it against Amir al-Mu'mineen? So we could fall into either category, either situation. Either sometimes it is extreme and harsh, either you choose Ali or you die, and sometimes no. It's either I sin or I don't. And this is where we, most of us, fall under. So if we want to hold on firm to this wilaya, to this concept of imama, if we want to sacrifice and give for the sake of Amir al-Mu'mineen, if we want to give for the sake of Ahl al-Bayt alayhim salam, just like the early companions of Amir al-Mu'mineen did, these guys gave their lives. The simplest thing I could do is to walk on the path of Amir al-Mu'mineen and walk towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and leave the road and the path of sins. As simple as that. وآخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة على محمد وآل بيته الطيبين الطاهرين.
اللهم صل على محمد.